माताजी 118th जयंती डे as we said these are the days when we try to brush up so many things, you know, which we were holding very close to our heart about Mataji. Every now and then we have to do that, you know, when we stack our books in an almara. They are there, we would have read, we would have kept. But it may not be active in our mind. So once in a while we remove all the books, clear the dust, and again restack it. And that activity will definitely connect us with the text, connect us with the situation that made us to get the text. And also it will make us to remember what we derived at the time of reading. It will be definitely beneficial. So similarly, on days like this, from our mental library, we take out one by one and try to remember. When we try to remember, you must have definitely observed, for example, those who have not had the privilege of meeting Mataji in body, especially when they go through the text called with the Divine Mother, authored by our dear Sudhanandji. Every day, you know, Mataji gives us not merely a high philosophy, but ordinary activity is linked to spirituality, as if we are living with her. At times she becomes serious, at times she becomes very, very simple and laughs, shares, like anyone. At times, you know, she takes us into task. We will go through the same today. One or two such episodes. Here Mataji is giving left and right to us. That also is needed, you know. The sadhaka should engage himself in constant self-examination. Checking on his own actions to see for himself if there was any trace of selfishness in them. Even the least bit of swartha in anything that he had said or done, whether it is there, we have to be conscious. The sadhaka should always put others' happiness above his own. Slowly unfolding the facets of absence of otherness, you know. Sadhaka should always put others' happiness above his own. He can never hope to progress on the spiritual path, making others miserable. It did not matter if, at times, he might have to sacrifice his own happiness. If his goal was indeed to behold Papa in all forms, and to realize Papa's universal being in his heart, he should be ready to make any sacrifices for others. That is possible only if the sadhaka is in constant introspection over his thoughts, words and actions. Others outside do not have to tell him, if he cares to turn the spotlight within, he would be able to judge for himself how and where he had erred. Every trace of selfishness has to be rooted out from one's heart and mind. So whatever you do, hold before you the criterion whether whatever you are going to do or say or even think will make others around you unhappy. If so, firmly desist from the same. Different people come here for different reasons. Some come for mental peace, some for solace after suffering some shock or bereavement, some for rest after an illness, and others for other reasons. Whatever be the reason they have come here for, everyone has got from Papa whatever they wanted. In spite of all that, it has not reduced their ego sense in the least measure, which is indeed the aim and purpose of all sadhana. If they did not have any spiritual inclination in the first place, or had not expressed that they were after sakshatkar, I would not have bothered about them. So many come here as if on an excursion or a holiday, spend some days here and then return home. Do I bother myself about them? But here were two elderly persons in the evening of their life, so to say, who said they wanted salvation, and my heart went out to them. I was anxious that they made the best possible use of the years left to them, so that they could attain Him, or be at least nearer to Him by intense remembrance. But for all that I said to them or did for them, they remained as steeped in worldly matters as ever, and I failed to make the least dent in their Dehabuddhi. And unless you shed your Dehabuddhi, how can you hope to attain Papa? My only anxiety is that you should attain Papa sooner or faster by shedding your Dehabuddhi, that is ego. But the Dehabuddhi itself acts as an obstruction to the path. The pity of it all is that you fail to even see this roadblock. Maybe I ought not to have picked up your faults and pointed out to you when and where you were, but then I would have failed in my duty to take you to Papa. But all my effort is of no use. you still cling on to your worldly desires, your tits and kin, and do not broaden your heart even by the least degree. So these are all coming from the heart of a mother, you know. 5 years still after petty things. So as we said yesterday, now probably we all realize that when we come here, we concentrate on the physical form. Mataji, as an earthly mother to all, was taking care of us in every aspect. In many devotees' life, without their asking, she had volunteered to do something which had helped them a lot, without even their asking. All those things are there in the mind. So we still forget, you know, the real content of matter. Seriously, we have to think about it. It is not possible for us to emulate those things because we are still not rooted in the idea. God, out of His mercy for us, places such Mahatmas in our midst. First to give us emotional satisfaction, sentimental satisfaction, even material satisfaction, initially. And then later on, you know, it becomes closer and closer, and then we start viewing not the person as a mere person, or the Mahatma. We try to ask ourselves, what is it that differentiates this Mahatma from the rest of the people? Like us. Why rest of the people? What is it that is there in them when I compare both? Then we come to know, yes, these are all the traits, the values which are explicit in their thoughts, words and deeds. That is the one which attracts me. Where from those traits come? It is not by an intellectual knowledge. It is purely from something which we don't know. Many people would have passed through many such trying moments as Mataji did. Either they reconciled to the situation or adapted to a new situation. So we start thinking, what is that, what is that, what is that? She would have easily managed to bring up the two children with the help of doctor and Sundariamma. They were very loving. But why she chose another one? Then we come to know that this is not her choice, God made it. God had sent her to this earth with the purpose of bringing out the nobler traits in her, so that many of people like us will get the benefit of it and start thinking about raising ourselves from the present level to her level. Think about all those things. So when we come here, as you all know, Mataji doesn't give a tall philosophy talk. In her own humble style, innocent style, spontaneous style, she expresses something to which we get really attracted. Not any words. Probably in many cases zero words. Her very presence. As we have shared this many, many, many times, once during our Vayanad day, when we were working with the Jain, both of us had to pass through this area. We were coming from Karkala. So we told the Jain we will go to ashram. Normally he doesn't go anywhere. He said, okay. So we passed with the vehicle. It was about 5 o'clock, 5:10 or 5:15. our idea was to immediately proceed. Because there's another 5 to 6 hours journey to reach Vayanad. We had almost reached Mahavangar, then we proposed. Immediately he said yes. When we stopped the vehicle, normally, you know, we rush up to Mataji group. The door is always open, no? Mataji was sitting there. As soon as Jain saw, no, he gave us Sadhgurgaranda Sastanga Pranam. We all did it, no? He sat there and told Mataji, we are coming from this place, we are on our way to Vayanad. We just wanted to have a darshan of Mataji, that's all. She did not stay, look here and there. She said, go and have your meal. She insisted 2-3 times. And then we looked at the Jain and told him, no time. We have no choice. He said, okay. When we came out, you know, this was the first reaction. Mataji is something special. The faith conveys serenity, peace, love, and it touches and kindles something which he cannot explain. There is no other task except in asking us to go for food. And when we reached in there, we looked at the wall clock, it was 5:50 or something like that. After 6 o'clock, this person will not take food. Immediately he connected up. Oh, that was why Mataji was insisting that we should go to canteen. In spite of our telling that we have to rush up. And after that we came and sat for 2.5 to 3 hours. Mataji was not giving us any lecture. Just to sit in her presence was giving us a lot of answers. Then we start thinking, what is it that makes us to become receptive to her silent teaching? So the purity of the heart, the care and concern of anybody, the absence of otherness, so many things come up before that. And where are we now? She says, you take your balance sheet to look. Where are we now? And then we find there are so many areas where we are yet to make a move. We try on the investment. When we go back to our field of activities, probably the impact may also slightly get diluted. Again, we either read something about them or somebody tells something about their visit to ashram. Again, we get slowly charged. But all these efforts should be towards what is the core of that Mahatma, you know? This is something on which we have to do a lot of thinking. Because if the instrumental cause like the form or the image or the photo or the book is not there, the impact is getting less and less in our day-to-day life. Now Mataji said you should be very careful that none of your thought, word and deed hurts anybody. Okay? We just read it. We want to live. We don't want to hurt anybody, going there to hurt anybody. But in our daily life, there may be many instances where unknowingly also we may hurt. At that time, do we feel? Oh, it could have been avoided. In other words, the word Mataji used, introspection. Every now and then, we have to do the introspection because we are dealing with so many situations every day which God makes us, you know, in varied, manifold forms. Somebody comes there in a loving form. Somebody comes there in an opposite form. Somebody comes there in a violent, aggressive manner. at least this introspection, no, will I shouldn't have jumped with him, I shouldn't have. That's why Mataji said, it will help you to know where you have erred. So even to do that introspection, we should link ourselves with her idea, you know. By hearing that we should do the introspection, we will not do any introspection. For the first 1 or 2 days we may do, immediately after the contact. And slowly, you know, preoccupations make us slowly move away from it. Now it is becoming very, very clear, in spite of our close association with the Mahatmas, in spite of our having our reverence, gratitude, gratefulness, everything is there towards them, the truth remains that we have not been able to invite them. So what should I do? Previously I was getting satisfied by just seeing, by looking, by having darshan, this and that. And it gave us some relief, no doubt. But after that, whether my kacha ego is becoming paka ego, whether the refinement is taking place, whether the broadening is taking place, whether the expansion of the love circle is taking place, whether we accommodate, we reconcile to testing situation. Are we in a position to absorb all shocks? So merely remembering them on these days is not sufficient. But these days should be instrumental in making us to plumb deep within the, about the core of our their personality. Then only we can say that they are there enough. People who are blessed like us, who know to be in the ashram, we have this everyday privilege of associating with these thoughts, you know, when we go to the room, we remember, we see the books, we remember many of the sharing which Pujya Swamiji had done about Mataji. All those things, you know, because this ambience provides us peace. But in spite of that, whether the expansion is taking place, we still remember, probably it might be, nobody would have connected up like that. We were sitting in the first room only, you remember, after Swamiji Samadhi. Nallima was insisting that we should go back to the present room. And when we went there, it so happened that we were sitting under the photo of Mataji. So every time morning when we come, you know, this is there. Are you trying to understand about the problems of others? Or you are just doing your administrative work? When somebody comes and goes, when we give prasad and go, you have maintained the same attitude. As if every day she is asking. So not through the form, but through the form to the for the thing which she stood for. Though when in body we never had any occasion to hear anything directly from her. Though she allowed her to watch so many of her talks and doings, She never told us anything or instructed us anything. But after that, when moving and sitting there, suddenly we saw the photos have been arranged in such a way that our feet happened to be just under Mataji. Like that, you know, probably if we try somehow, we fail, suppose at times when we fail, we used to tell her, no? Why did you make us to fail this time? The circumstance or the situation was such, it had to be responded in that manner. But we know it should have been done from a different level or an angle. Kindly guide us. Never allow us to do like that. Like that, you know, the communication should also be there. So, what we are trying to understand is, through the form, to the formless idea she represented. So whenever we think about or talk about Pooja Mataji, all these things come always well up in our hearts. Not merely the form. The struggle is now to keep it up and percolate it to our thought, words and deeds. Which she only can do it. At the time of thinking or at the time of talking or at the time of reacting, she must influence us. But it should never be from the basis of this devotee. It should always be from a higher level. So on this day, we keep on trying, placing ourselves before her. You make us to read many of your thoughts. You make us to remember how you dealt with different situations, different manners. But all the same, you were able to have the same, you develop the same feeling in everybody's heart. Nobody felt bad why you talk like this, because everybody knows it is coming from the heart of a mother. And you had no sense of otherness. So a person who is having this absence of otherness will also behave like any ordinary people, but their mind is pure. She made us to go through the letter, no? That was written in 1938, must have been okayed by Papa and brought out in the form of, in translated in English. There she gives us the clue that even after scaling the height, people who are dealing with the, dealing on the universal plane, when they come down as an individual, they will exhibit in their daily activities the ordinary ways of responding and reacting. So that helped us to get clear, you know. That is why, when, for all the practical purposes, when Mataji was taking so many people to task, why is she doing that? That question will not come. Because then the earthly mother, you know, from the universal mother, she comes to the earthly mother of the individual, and reacts. But both, you know, the care and concern for others, that is the scope, free from total self-interest. That is purity. Purity is totally free from self-interest of any kind. And from the cosmic level, they come down to the individual level and react. And in Mataji's case, we can definitely say that she was the mother of all. So a mother not only appreciates facts, mother also will take their children into task when they go off the line. No? So there is no confusion at all. Now the question is, so now we know that from the person of birth, we see the form, she is always getting connected to the formless aspect in her mind. That is why she was able to maintain the absence of otherness and at the same time behaving through that form. These are all something which inward journey will definitely help us to know. We don't know how far we have made all these things clear. But we request all of you to kindly think over this. From the form to the formless. At the same time retaining our reverence, our gratitude, our commitment to the form. But not merely the form. Today morning when we were reading, you know, in the Bhajan hall, he specifically said that form is there, but it comes and goes. But when we know the impersonal aspect, it stays in us. That will help in our spiritual journey. The other one may not help us much. But from her own experience, Papa taught her, and she is also revealing it from her own experience. Probably that's why she was insisting that in the home mandir there should not be any images, no rituals, nothing like that. So we try to raise ourselves from the individual level to the formless level. Since God willed it in another way, now that's why in the centenary hall there is no photo there. So when we go there, we can try our level best. To be free from all conditioning and make a peep into the nameless, formless aspect. So these are all the thoughts she is actuating in us. And so we now pray to her, guide us, help us, lead us to have the experience of the cosmic reality in us while retaining the sense of individuality through these forms. First you should make me aware, then only I will be able to see the same thing in everyone, which alone can pave the way for absence of otherness. So what is, we fully understand when you said so much importance about getting ourselves released from the Dehabuddhi. So only when we get ourselves freed from the Dehabuddhi, we will be able to move towards the Vishwatmabuddhi. And once that is taking place, then naturally we will try to understand it is there in everyone. Until such time it is only academic for us. Somebody says we are repeating that thought. So this Dehabuddhi, 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 many of you might have heard it from Mataji's own mouth. We will try to concentrate upon that, how to lift ourselves up from that level to a higher level. Let that be the take-home message for all of us on this auspicious day. Hari Om. Om Shri Ram Jai Ram. Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om
Shri Ram Jai Ram
Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram
Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om Shri Ram Jai Ram Jai Jai Ram Om
Shri Ram Jai Ram
राम जय राम जय राम वो
राम जय राम जय राम
श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम
राम जय राम जय राम
श्री राम जय राम श्री राम ओम श्री राम जय राम जय जय राम हरि ओम टू एवरीबॉडी हरि ओम हरि ओम हरि ओम हरि ओम